Hello everyone. Welcome to our channel, Information Briefcase. Today we're going to learn about things that were legal in old days. Now, let's begin. Imagine yourself holding a pot in public. Indeed, today something like that is legally wrong. But in olden days this was not illegal. However, a century ago you'd be shocked at the legal system in which many things which are illegal today were legal in history. Number 1. Driving under influence. Today there are relatively few different ways of destroying your life totally than to get a DUI charge. In the US, a DUI can cost you almost $20,000 in legitimate costs and fines, notwithstanding a strong likelihood of jail time and suspension of your license without a doubt. It's not actually stunning that society caught down so serious with this incredibly hazardous activity anyway. From the second that the vehicles was available, somebody was crushed under their vehicle. Generally, in light of the fact that our ancestors used to drink a lot, it was not a problem when people used carriages for transportation, because even when a carriage driver was drunk, he would either kicked out by the horse or he falls down himself. It would not cause any serious danger to other people in the carriage. But the automobiles enabled fundamentally serious killing power in the hands of a heavy drinkers who drive. In 1910, New York saw the risk of crushed driving and executed the United States' first law against drunk driving. California hurried to make a move in like manner, and various states bit by bit followed. At any rate, prerequisite was not uniform, and what definitively settled alcoholic driving wasn't genuinely cleared. With the exception of, if the subject was obviously stunning heavy drinker. During the 1930s, public DUI laws transformed into a lot harder as the country's street system slowly created and expanded. The National Safety Council accepted its own survey to endeavor to encourage methods of testing for intoxication and unequivocally measure precisely how intoxicated an individual was. By 1930, quite far for blood alcohol level was set at 0.15. As manufacturing of vehicles exploded during the 70s, so did intoxicated driving offenses also increased. This initiated more outrageous disciplines for drunk driving, which made raising of the drinking age from 18 to 21 and changing quite far to a basic alcohol level of 0.10. During the 90s, this was dropped to just 0.08. Number 2. Mercenary killers. In 1989, the Geneva Convention officially restricted the usage of recruited warriors in battle, but in 2001 the United Nations Mercenary Convention made the law of restricting the usage of employed fighters even more harder, which was simply embraced by 35 countries. That was inspiring news for the United States, who planned to restore the world's second most prepared occupation. Nobody knows the beginning stages of mercenary killers, yet they were a huge piece of human history. In the pre-Westphalian country, recruited warriors were the manner in which they fought wars. Military stuff was unimaginably costly, and without anything taking after current creating systems, weapon forgers would be constrained to work for a long time on individual pieces of stuff at a time. Work was a significant issue too, as every occupant got into organization as an worker was one less seller or farmer. This hurt your economy too, leading to starvation if farmers were pulled away from their properties. To be sure, war was basically not fought during planting or harvest seasons for this reasons. Recruited warriors at any rate were men who made their living from viciousness. Also, they can be used without upsetting your local economy. Moreover, they brought their own stuff, saving you seemingly hard work and money. Even in modern times, the US war in Afghanistan and Iraq bought back mercenary business again. They faced with a fundamental lack of staff to fight two separate wars, the US expected to either build up a draft or select recruited warriors. At one point there were anyway numerous private military specialists in Iraq and Afghanistan as normal US troops. Mercenaries were not only used by the US and Russian state-run organizations, but by countless private associations hoping to guard their workplaces in remarkably eccentric spaces of the world. Nations use them against each other in mock battle against one another, example the Battle of Qasim. This battle in Syria happened across 2 days in February of 2018 in Syria, when around 500 steady of government fighters attacked a little force of 40 American commando team and a humble pack of Syrian Democratic Forces accomplices. Though Russian government refused the war, it was hence found that Russian mercenary soldiers had led the attack. The battle would end with one SDF fighter harmed and 55 to more than 100 of the adversary power killed, along with destruction of innumerable tanks and intensely clad vehicles. Unofficial news said that between 80 to 218 Russian employed mercenaries were killed in the attack. Number 3. Child labor. Everybody cherishes their kids in modern times, but in older days individuals loved their kids somewhat less than they needed to. Life used to be really extreme for individuals, and everyone was expected to contribute just to make it one more year. When mankind started to settle down in one place and fabricated relationship among themselves. They did it on the backs of the farmers whose work it was to take care of everyone. The change from wanderer-finder to an agrarian culture was because farmers could produce sufficient food. Sufficient food changed humans from going to places for food and enabled to stay in one place. But do not forget that from the beginning kids were relied upon to do a lot of labor as they grown up. This implied merciless hours of labor, awakening a long time before sunlight to feed domestic animals. Backbreaking work pulling weeds, plowing fields, planting and collecting crops. It was very nearly a 24-hour issue, and the effect for not doing the work will lead to complete starvation. Kids were also used to grow their family tree more, they were forced to reproduce more children. The more people in the family will be helpful in the farming work. And also the farmers usually give their farmlands and domestic animals when they die to keep the farming going on. However, city kids didn't have it much better, a portion of the jobs in which they did were risky positions. Where they would be covered in cruel and deadly chemicals, or digging through the open-faced trash dumps of the age for resources worth selling. Even kids were trained to do pickpockets, and stealing as they were kids they can escape from law easily. They were not allowed to go to school or get any form of education, they were fed less as poverty were high in society until the Industrial Revolution started, individuals' ways of life improved, flow of money increased. But the owner of the industries preferred kids rather than adults. Since youngsters were more cheap and could fit in tight places that couldn't be reached by adults, they were a top choice for workers. A significant number of these youngsters even resided in dorms allotted by the industry owners. They were allowed only to return to their homes on the ends of the week. It was normal for supervisors to distribute cruel actual punishments for poor or slow execution. Kids' small hands could squeeze into intense small places on machines to fit it. What's more, regularly the machines wouldn't be shut down while repairing them. For the sake of benefit and efficiency, incalculable youngsters were killed or lost their hands, until at last in the mid-1900s youngster work laws started to be framed. Number 4. Prostitution. Our next thing that used to be lawful in old days is one of the oldest profession in history. However, while today you can confront solid punishments for either requesting or doing prostitution, it wasn't not long in the past that the practice wasn't simply lawful, it was fundamentally a piece of culture. Sumerian records tracing all the way back to 2400 BC are the latest records we have found about our world. These records tell us clearly how prostitution was legal and how it was practiced among many society. No one knows without a doubt when prostitution was made legal. Yet, it's practically sure that its beginnings date back to the absolute first human settlements, when ladies found they could obtain wealth, security, and also administrative powers from men longing for sex. They started using this as a weapon against powerful peoples, even against kingdoms which they bought down from inside. To be reasonable, the ancient world had its reasonable portion of both male and female sex workers. Prostitution was legitimate in the vast majority of the world, yet it was also really holy in certain social society. The whole way across close to East, different groups and society constructed tombs and temples housed by sacred sex workers, as sex was viewed as perhaps the most ideal way of gravitating toward to the divine beings. In the Americas, the Aztecs permitted prostitution in extraordinary structures called sahuacali, a word that implies house of women. Strict specialists trusted that assuming ladies needed to function as sex workers, in these pseudo-sanctuaries, where they could work under the security of Tlazoltiatl, the goddess of purity, steam showers, birthing specialists, foulness, also, adulterers. Quick forward to Europe in the medieval times and prostitution was doing great. It was believed that prostitution stopped more genuine sins like assault, homosexuality, and masturbation. Although, the happy times wouldn't last longer as sexual transmitted illnesses increased in the late 15th. Also, mid-16th century which led to banning of prostitution. In America, prostitution was generally accepted, once more seen as a necessary evil to prevent greater evil. It was even acceptable for a married man to solicit the services of a prostitute if his wife didn't want to have sex with him. However, as the 19th century attitudes towards prostitution also changed, eventually leading to the outright banning except in very few select places in the country. Today prostitution is illegal in all but 10 counties in Nevada. Thank you for watching the video. If you enjoyed this video, Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment below. Please press the bell button to get notification.